What's up, guys? We're gonna do a another movie study, frame study from Zatoichi. I don't know which movie this is from, but. Gonna do this in Clip Studio Paint CSP file new blah 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 blah. Okay. Import image. Desktop. Zatoichi. Here we go. And voila. Gonna get a little bit bigger. Flip the screen. No, that's not it. What is this? 100% reset rotation. Layer. Layer settings? No. Layer? No. Edit, maybe. Transform, FAE, distorts Q. No, anyways, okay. See, I know in Photoshop you can center your image, you know, a line on the left or a line on the right, or if you want your whole image to be spot dead on center. And in Clip Studio Paint, since I just started using this, I'm not totally aware of if there is such a feature. So I'm just fishing left and right to see if maybe it would be a function. Move object at the click, no. Move layers in this exit, no. Move layers becomes a no. Move grid, move tone, move layer. What is this? This is Snap their grid. Okay, maybe. Nope. This is snap to ruler, okay. And snap to special ruler. Scale rotate. Undo. Select quick mask view. It should be in layer though. Mirror setting. I don't know. Set as draft layer, show layer, change layer. Merge with layer below. Edit maybe again. Image register material. No. Restore. No. No. Okay. Well, whatever. So what you want to do is copy this, duplicate layer, always keep your original layer safe, so I lock it down, and I use this one over here, which I'm going to do my stuff. A layer over here, this layer over here, this is going to be the sketch layer, sketch, okay, pen, pencil, mapping, yeah, too big. What is going on? Okay. Mechanical pen's kind of cool, huh? Yeah, really nice textures. Mechanical pen is nice. So, I'm gonna go with mechanical pen. Okay. So this is what we refer to as a two shot. There's two, there's only two characters, two individuals in the frame, and they're both, I would say, they're close-ups. Okay. And, he's in the foreground. He's in the middle ground. Excuse me. Okay. What you want to do is try to one stroke, like so. And rotate your canvas so that you're comfortable drawing in your natural angle. People don't flip their canvases enough, and I think if they would only take the time to do so, it would solve a lot of issues. You see, like right now, that chin, just pin it, spin your canvas. That's my angle right here. It's like, I don't know, So this is 90 and I'm like right here, that's 45, and yeah, I guess it's, yeah, I'm at a 45 degree angle right here. So that's my sweet spot. Right. And the trick in doing these type of studies is to, one, build your confidence when you're drawing, and in your stroke, you know, one confident stroke. And at the same time, you're putting in the pencil mileage that you need to do every day and every week for the rest of your life, because that's the job. Right. So that's enough over here. I'm just gonna boost a little bit. Yeah. Okay. Maybe 65. Yeah, 65. Okay. You're building your shape language as well when you're sketching on top like this. You know, be aware of the shape that you're sketching. You know, this is more like a triangle kind of shape. You know, and you got the round and then another triangle or cone, yeah, triangle. A cylinder and then an inverted cone. There we go. And that's basically it right now. So these are going to be my dudes. Layer, and this is going to be my background layer, BG layer. not a whole hell of a lot to draw, so this is going to be a quick frame. And on top, right here, I'm going to do my borders. Oh. Here we go. Whoa, okay, that's not what I wanted, but what? Okay, it creates a mask. Oh, that's nice. Okay. I'm not totally familiar with how to use it though. Overlay, I guess. Multiply. Okay. True. No. Okay, well, anyways, that's not really what I wanted, but, cut frame? Divide? Probably frame border pen, I guess. That would make sense, right? Not totally familiar on what to do here, so okay, no, that's not it. Okay. Let's go back to, I want to explore this another time. Polygon, polyline. What the hell is polyline? What does polyline do? Okay. It sort of works. Let's beef this up a little bit. 8. Ah, there we go. Nice and clean. It's gonna be border. Okay. This is gonna be my tones. BG tone. And dudes tone as with my fill lasso fill. Right here. And at this point, what I usually like to do is create another copy of my photo, duplicate, bring it back up to 100%, take this and shrink it down a little bit, like so, move it down here, can just take out the original one. And I want to eyeball the tones. I want to be able to eyeball it, you know. Dude's tones. So this is probably going to be black, but I'll go 20 first, just because why not, you know? Over here, voila. Inside here, yes. Leave this on top here. And here, yeah, I guess we could go 40. You know what? Just put the whole thing at 40, like so. This is probably going to be, yeah, black over here. And his lips, nostril a little bit. Yeah, not that. Leave it. And yeah, that's too harsh. It's too harsh, man. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. Something like that, maybe. Yeah, I'll get back to it, anyways. And Zatoichi over here. Should probably do this instead and come back after. Like so. So this is, that's 40% right here. So it's going to be lighter on top. So let's go up in value then. 60. Either, yeah, 60. I think 60 is gonna be, it's gonna do the trick. Yep. Always keep in mind that when you have a white surface like this among a dark surface, the white surface is always going to seem brighter than what it actually is. So that's an illusion. So you got to pay attention to that. And vice versa with if you do the darks in a very bright area, your darks are gonna they're gonna seem more more dark in terms of tonal range, in terms of value, sorry. So inside the rim over here, that should be on top though. On top of the rim, inside. You got these little streaks. The technically the board is really is already done, so the only thing that I'm doing right now is I'm just fishing for some tones, and it's personal practice at this point. Personal I don't know how to say it. It's personal taste, And this, I'm gonna go with 40%. Okay, here's the thing though. Can I guess? Nope, that's not it. The other way around. Yeah, okay. To our selection tool, rectangle, and we're just gonna delete. Whoa, gotta add though. That's the minus. Okay, there we go. What? What is this? Okay, there we go. Nope. What the hell, man? Obviously, I don't know how to use this thing, so I want to create a rectangle, but it's always giving me this cube. Okay, there we go. What the hell happened here, man? Okay. Nope. That's not what I want. Okay, there we go. Take that out. Take that out. And that should be, yep, that should be it. There's something weird now up here. Is that in my selection? Yeah, it was my selection. Crap! Crap! Okay, I'll start over. Sure, if I'm can I? Yes, I can. Ooh, nice. Okay. That's up here. Just a little bit. Nope, that's too low. One, two. Yep, still too low. Nope, this time, there we go. And I like that over here. Yeah, at this point you're just refining and retouching the little touch-ups that, you know, don't look that neat. So I can't remember if yeah, it's white, huh? The cord over here is white, well, sort of white. It's more like off-white. Try this. No, that's part of his face, bro. That's the thing over here. There we go. And I think there's even. Yep. Right underneath his lip there. Something like that. Which I'm gonna do with the pencil. And over here. Spin that around a little bit. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay. Nope, that's too black now. That's not the right pencil. Mechanical. There we go. No, I could take this. Yeah, I think. Goes all the way up here. Whoa, whoa. No, that's not it. I need this. Over here. Goes like this. Up. All the way here. That's white. There's some black over there. Black over here. I fear that's way too black, though. It's way too black. And this. What is this? That's 40? If I go 20, no, it's the same thing as this. Yeah, that's 20. Okay, leave it like that then. We could take the white now, maybe. Nope, that's not good. That would be good for the rope thing. There's a that's hotspot. Hotspot is brighter than the rest of the sky. So yeah. Same thing on the edges over here. Yep. Two tones. Okay, I thought I put something black over here, no? Pretty sure I did. Oh yeah, okay, I went over. Yeah, okay. I don't know, man, that looks weird to me. Looks weird, man. I'm just fishing for details here that I don't really need, so anyways. Yep. Looking good. Just gonna try something here. Do you think that sort of works? Sort of works, huh? Yep. And this over here, we're just going to redo this part because it's not what it is, man. It's this over here. Yep. I could even maybe. Nope. Leave it like that. Yeah, all right, so that's it. This one. Okay. Over here. The original one. It's not. There's a. I know there's a way to. There we go. That's what I want. Okay. Save this file, save as. Clip. Frame study 03, let's say. There we go. And that's one done. All right. So, I'll call it quits, and I'll try to do another one tomorrow. So thanks for watching, guys. Catch you tomorrow. Bye-bye.